Zaragon here. I have assimilated more than 17,000 albums from around the world in my 35 years as a music connoisseur. To explore the journey in depth, see the Trimax Music Database on RYM and the Directory of American Artists on jazzrocksoul.com, both linked in the description below. While you're at it, hit the like and subscribe buttons and the bell and share this video. Today, we're going to listen to three tracks by three different jazz funk artists from 1975. And the first of those is David Sanctius from his debut solo album, The Forest of Feelings, the title track. Thank you. David Sanctius with The Forest of Feelings, the title track from his 1975 debut album as a band leader, composer arranger, having graduated from the E Street Band in 1974. And began with this incredible syncopated, odd meter interplay at the beginning with that crisp piano amid bass line and ostinato and such, and intricate drumming goes through, and then along that ostinato pattern, plays some great fills, really hyperactive ivory work, and then switching to, I guess, an arp. Let's see, on this album, he plays Hammond, Moog, electric piano, clavinet. Okay. Yeah, the Moog. At first, I was having a hard time identifying what I was hearing. It was like, I almost thought I was hearing. I just kind of stopped. I was putting my ear close and I was thinking, am I hearing a fretboard? Am I hearing a keyboard? Am I. Anyway, and then later on goes through that kind of slower passage with that kind of steamy synth sound beckoning in. This album produced by Billy Cobham, and while he doesn't drum on it, Ernest Carter plays drums here. He does play timpani on this track. Yeah, and goes through quite a few sections, this number, recapitulating the intro theme with the odd meter and such. And much more rock, like progressive rock in orientation, I would say this piece. I actually didn't hear a lot of funk. I'm hearing more kind of like a Return to Forever and progressive rock, perhaps like ELP kind of as starting points for this. And Sanctius was largely responsible for the arrangements on what a lot of people have cited as Springsteen's best album, The Wild, the Young, and the E Street Shuffle. The Wild, the Innocent, and the E Street Shuffle. Yeah, his second album from 1973. His most varied and maximalistic album with quite a few unexpected arrangements, some big band stuff, and all that. Yeah. Now on to our next piece of the set. Doug Hammond and David Hurrah from the 1975 album Reflections in the Sea of Nernen. This is the track Fidalgo Detour. Fidalgo Detour by Doug Hammond and David Durra. Basically composed of four components, had that great soprano sax on it, those diamondy, glistening Fender Rhodes keys, some choice bass notes anchoring the piece, coming to the fore during select passages, that cymbal, selectively placed and creating just as much atmosphere and mist as it did timekeeping. The two guys who are ahead of the bill do play the lion's share. Duras plays piano, electric Fender Rhodes, Moog & Arp on the album, and co-engineered the album with a drummer, Doug Hammond, who also plays a melodica harp on the album. And let's see here. And this track was written by Charles Metcalf, who is the bassist. And he also plays like stand-up bass elsewhere on the album. Anyway. And this Reflections in the Sea of Nernan came out on the Tribe label. It's got one of those classic covers. Kind of looks like something on the Black Jazz label or Anyway, now on to the final piece of the set, Eddie Henderson, and the track Explodition. Thank you. That was Eddie Henderson with Explodition, quite a play on words there, from his 1975 release Sunburst. Yes, I've profiled Eddie Henderson before. Did a track or two off Inside Out, his 1974 release about a year ago on here. And this track is just an all-star release. The track itself is written by George Duke, who gives us all that spacey keyboard that comes filtering in at times. He plays a mini Moog, Arp Odyssey, Arp String Ensemble on the album Clavinet. Yeah, and this song we had like a really tight thematic moment that reoccurred with interplay between trumpet player Eddie Henderson and saxist Benny Maupin, who plays tenor sax and sax solo on this album, and some really deft bass lines, electric bass from Alfonso Johnson, and yeah, and we went through the thematic section. We went through Henderson Spotlight, then kind of that funky break, and then through Maupin Spotlight. Yeah, and produced by Skip Drinkwater. Yeah, and elsewhere on the album, double bassist Buster Williamson and marimbaist Bobby Hutcherson appear. Obviously not on this track, though. Anyway, and this was recorded March, April 75, Wally Heider Recording Studios, San Francisco. Yeah, and it's got a great cover with kind of like this. Oh, light just flaring up, right in front of our guy. Anyway, for more rubies and sapphires from American jazz funk artists, see the directory of albums by, well, American jazz funk artists, linked in the description below for Red Hot Tracks and Purples from Eddie Henderson, Doug Hammond, Dave Sanchez, their catalogs, as well as many others. Including the last video profile I did, this linked in the cards, and many others. See the list, the playlist of jazz funk fusion that I've covered on this channel over the last year and a half. Upwards of like 180 videos, I think, at this point. Yeah. Like and subscribe, follow me on social media, share the video, and leave a comment if there are any observations you have about the three tracks we just heard: the interplay, the harmonics, the counterpoint, the musicianship, the soloing. Who had the best moment? And until next time, this is Aragon, the world's most ear-traveled trem maximalist, signing off.